Good morning from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to today's International Space Station update. The crew began their day waking up at about midnight Central Time today, and then moving into a daily planning conference where they discuss the day's activities with controllers on the ground. Commander Dan Burbank is spending much of his day and is actively working right now on the high-rate communication system, doing some cable routing and replacing a few wires on board the station. He will also be doing some camera checks on the BCAT experiment that he was working on yesterday, and also doing some solo or sodium loading diet logging. That solo experiment looks at the different mechanisms of fluid and salt retention in the body during space flights and prescribes the astronauts a very strict diet of either constant or low sodium intakes. Meanwhile, Russian cosmonaut Anton Shkaplerov is doing another biomedical experiment with the Immuno research project, taking some biological samples and then storing them. He will also be spending a good portion of his day reviewing the preliminary timeline for his upcoming spacewalk on February 16th. That is a six-hour spacewalk scheduled to attach some debris shields to the Vesta service module and then relocate two of the cranes on some of the docking modules. Russian cosmonaut Anatoly Ivanishin will also be taking some samples for that Immuno experiment and then spending much of his day doing some maintenance work inside of the Zvezda and Zarya modules, inspecting the windows on the respective compartments and also doing some changeouts on some dust collectors. The final Russian cosmonaut, Oleg Kononenko, will also be reviewing that timeline as he will be going out on the spacewalk with Shkaplerov on February 16th. And he's also doing some unloading work from the Progress 46 spacecraft that arrived last Friday. European astronaut ANDRÉ KUIPERS started his day off doing some body mass measurements using the SLAMMED, or the Space Linear Acceleration Mass Measurement device, which is a unique device on station that uses springs to generate a force against a crew member, and then the resulting acceleration is used to calculate each crew member's mass. He is also changing out a lens and some batteries on the Earth Cam, which is the Earth knowledge acquired by middle school students, and that is one of the many education projects linking students here on the ground to the astronauts up in space. And then our final Expedition 30 crew member, Don Pettit, is spending his day doing a fairly interesting and fun experiment called the Lego Bricks Experiment, which saw a series of Lego kits flown to the station and then are assembled on orbit and used to demonstrate various scientific concepts. Some of these models include different satellites, a space shuttle orbiter, and a scale model of the International Space Station.